This was to be Scott Harrison's third world title defense, having beaten Julio Pablo Chacon and Wayne McCulloch previously. Manuel Medina was a wily veteran with 17 world title fights under his belt. His career was on the decline.
An atmosphere to rival those thunderous nights when Jim Watt was defending his world lightweight title at the Calvin Hall and Ibrox over 20 years ago. Harrison is today's hero. There is Medina in his 75th pro fight. What a fighter he's been. And he's already been involved in a couple of little mini classics on visits to these islands against Nassim Hamed and also against Paul Ingall. But he ended up losing them both. In fact, his record in 18 World Championship fights is 1-9, lost 9. And just when you think he's going away for good, he comes back and picks up a world title again. Will it happen tonight? Have they underestimated what this man can do? Harrison officially 8-13 and 3 quarters, probably weighing something like 10 stone on the night. This is a lightweight, I think, masquerading as a featherweight, don't you, once he gets in there?
I think it is. He's so big and so strong for a featherweight, and I think that's the surprise that his opponents have when they get in the ring with him. They feel that strength.
Wayne McCulloch, who's been around, said in that last fight he could not believe just how strong Scott Harrison is. But Medina says, as far as I'm concerned, he's a boy. I'll win every round. Circumspect start from Harrison, who is outreached. Medina, who threw 1,466 punches, a world record in his fight with Johnny Tapia, and still didn't get the decision.
He's only doing but long range in this opening round, just not really hard shots, just poking that jab out and trying to get the arms moving, Medina.
Well, I think a lot of his punches are little range finders. He's not a puncher, but he has heart, strength, determination, experience, and height and reach advantages here. And that praying mantis type style that was referred to in the introductions. Good in and out work from Medina. Harrison not doing a lot early.
He's not, he just seems a little bit mesmerized, maybe a bit cold in this opening round, not getting close, he's been picked off with long-range shots from Medina.
This is far different to fighting Wayne McCulloch, who's always right in front of you. And Chacon was never that far away either on the night that Harrison won his world championship. At the moment, he's struggling a bit with the speed and height and movement of Medina, who's made much the better start. Struggling to work him out early.
He is. I mean, one of the problems are he's a bit upright, and that means he gets hit with straight shots. Medina is able to hit him because that's his style.
Harrison does get there with a left hook, and the cheers ring around this Greyhead Arena, but it's Medina's opening round. He's already done better than Wayne McCulloch did. Featherweight history have had more world title fights than this fellow, Manuel Medina. That's George Dixon, A. Battel, and Eusebio Pedroza. And he was tricky in this opening round.
He was tricky. He just showed, you know, what he can do, his experience, and the fact that he's probably looking at Harrison, seeing he gets picked up with jabs, and he used that punch well.
Round two. Medina only stopped twice in this world championship career by Nassim Hamed, and that was late, and also last time out when he was beaten up really by the underrated IBF champion Juan Manuel Marquez, yet another Mexican. I think they must keep the belts in the Rio Grande.
Well, they do breed them tough in Mexico, natural fighters.
Harrison needing to get closer. He's getting picked off from range at the moment. Medina having things his own way, but is it only a matter of time before Harrison works out a way? Just to cut off those corners a bit.
Well, it's the long arms and the movement that is giving Harrison the problems so far. So he's got to move that head a little bit and just step inside the range of Medina and get it. Touches going.
Harrison going for the body, trying to slow down Medina. Surely has to come a point where all these fights start to catch up with Medina, who's starting to chip a couple now. Harrison is beginning to solve the problems.
Well, he's just got to get in range to be able to solve them. Just falling a bit short, but as soon as he gets in range, he can then land Harrison.
A lot of these punches Medina throws are simply arm punches. Some of them have got a bit more about them, like the one that knocked out Nassim Hamed's gum shield.
Shot to the body from Medina, who's still using plenty of movement and catching Harrison from long range.
A lot of these experienced world-class operators from the other side of the Atlantic basically don't believe Brits can fight, do they?
No, that's the problem. I think they're learning with the likes of Joe Calzaghe and Lennox Lewis that they can a bit.
And Harrison will be looking to ram home the point here. He's just looked a shade mesmerized early on. Maybe that ice-cold boxing brain of his is just working a few things out in there. It is still early.
Well, the light punches from Medina, but they're getting through and they're pretty quick.
There's a nice right hand from Harrison. Really light on his feet, Manuel Medina. He makes the weight easily. Before he fought Paul Ingle, he had fish and chips at the press conference. That's better from Harrison. Good left hook, twice over.
But he needs more Robin Harrison. Trying to get closer. Medina skips out of range.
There were signs of encouragement in that round, though, for Harrison. Dad Peter, nearer the camera, Denny Mancini, the cuts man on the far side, out of vision, Billy Nelson. It's the old team with Scott Harrison.
Just starting to get a bit closer towards the end of the round, but Medina's still doing more and just frustrating him.
Judges, two from America, and Britain's experienced former ref Roy Francis doing the scoring of this one. Just wonder whether there are a few clues as to how this might develop in that last round. It's a different little puzzle tonight. Harrison is caught by a fast right. I think he'd prefer to have someone who is in front of him. Mover like this, sometimes just making him look a little ponderous.
Well, that's something that we're learning. The movement and the fast hands are giving Harrison trouble.
Good strategy by Medina, who of course knows what he's about. And that's one, two, three jabs, wrapping back the head of Medina.
And that's more of what he needs from Harrison, getting closer. He's got to keep your one punch is not enough. As you saw, the jab's got to be two or three.
I think if that left hand had landed, it would have put Medina into the nearby supermarket.
Into the body as well, Medina.
It's a nice short little left on the inside. There's no doubt here Harrison is in with one of the elite level featherweights, and his legs just moved a little, Medina, then after that left hook landed. He's been on the floor plenty of times in his career. He was down against Hamed and against Ingle on his visits over here before.
This is better. He's got Medina much more on the run now. Getting through some solid shots, Harrison.
More authoritative punches from Harrison. There's something of a pitter-patter nature about arm punches from Medina. Not all of them, but quite a lot. Sometimes he gives the... It's an illusion that he's busy, isn't it?
Yes, and he's just giving Harrison a little bit more respect, a little bit more wary about putting his shots on. Just falling short, Medina.
Just wondering whether he'll be able to dance like this for 12 rounds as well. Harrison, classic tactics against a guy doing this, looking to hit him to the body, slow him down. Weaken the body, the legs will go. So the argument goes, anyway. Fascinating clash of styles, Glenn.
Yes, it is, with this ever-moving style of Medina's in and out. Certainly is giving Harrison something to think about, but this round he's been better, just starting to land with the solid punches.
Round four coming up for the WBO Featherweight Championship. Second defence this by Scott Harrison, who's never dodged the column all through his career. Even in his 12th fight, he was fighting former world champion Tracy Harris Patterson. Then Tom Johnson, the long-reigning IBF champion. And that was just by way of learning the business. Only wants to fight big names. He's doing it again tonight.
Well, you admire that about Scott Harrison. Well, he is determined. He does really want to be the best out there. He doesn't want to avoid anybody.
Medina looks like he's throwing a bit more leather, but I think the extra solidity of shot is coming from Harrison. Not that he's looking that sharp, is he?
No, he's not. He's a little bit bemused by the punches coming in. It could do with just trying to slip a few more, a little bit more head movement, side to side movement would help Harrison. I've always felt that.
Watched him with the left hook, then up the body punch as well. Bit by bit, Harrison, with those eyes that look like ice on fire, just starting to close the range. But he's full of it, isn't he? Medina loves it, fully intends to become a five-time world champion tonight. He'd be Mexico's first if he did it.
Constantly on the move, left and right, throwing punches out. That is giving Harrison the trouble of just getting to him. Harrison just early on this fight looking a little bit flat and needing to get some shots off.
He's every punch being cheered by the Glasgow crowd, of course. Judges shouldn't be taking any notice of that. Still looks confident. Medina still looks fresh. How's he do this? Defies boxing logic, this guy.
Couple of good shots there, go from Harrison, just rocking the head a little bit of Medina. You know the Harrison punches have much more effect when they land.
He's got to make them count when he does get to them. There's a bit of blood around from somewhere. Is that coming from the nose of Harrison?
Yep, I think these jabs and straight rights have give Harrison a bit of a problem with the nose, and there is a little bit of blood about. He is plenty busy, isn't he, Manuel Medina?
Yeah, no wonder he threw 1,400 punches in the fight against Tapia. But it's quality question mark about the shots. Well, let's hear of another Scottish boxing hero now, Gary Jacobs. He's with Ed Robinson.
Well, Gary, Medina's setting Scott Harrison some new problems in his career.
Absolutely. He's taller, he's a lankier man. He's playing like the jab and the move. Scott's got to get in front of him, he's got to pressurise him. And what he's doing at the moment, he's getting in front of him and he's following him about. He's got to come in behind his jab. He has to start working and putting him under a bit of pressure, because all Medina's doing is just jabbing and moving and flicking away, and he's stealing the round. Scott has to get in front and and put him under pressure with punches, not just following him about.
Is it a style problem, or is Scott Harrison just making a slow start tonight?
Right, his style. Styles make fights. I mean, Medina's tall and lanky. He's got the longer reach. He's always going to be doing that. He's staying out of distance. He's staying out of the way, and he's jabbing and moving, and just it's the wee flicking punches that's picking up points. He's not really hurting Scott. Scott has to put a bit more pressure on him.
Thank you, Gary.
The computer says that Medina is throwing more and landing more. That they haven't invented a computer yet that can tell you about the weight and quality of the punches.
That's right, it's a 12-round fight, and Harrison will be looking to make those punches pay later in the fight.
Nice right hand from Harrison that time. Sending the sweat spraying from the grizzled Manuel Medina. Nickname Manticas, which translates as smooth. And at times he's looked just that tonight. Oh, right hand, a big shot to the temple from Harrison. Medina takes it.
Well, that was much better. You know Harrison can do it when he gets his punches off, gets the combinations working. That's when he's at his best.
Starting to land more regularly. Tripling up with the jab and the right hand. Harrison does have trouble getting down to 9 stone, though. I know he's been in the 90-degree hit of Tenerife for a lot of the training. Starting to slow a little, maybe, here, Medina, maybe.
Well, Harrison just starting to wake up a little bit, pick it up.
Great left hand to the body, right into the ribcage by Harrison. That was a quality shot.
Medina just defy his age and the number of fights he's had. Just keeps flicking out them shots.
Well, he gives trouble to just about everybody he fights except Juan Manuel Marquez, who beat him fair and square in 7.
Well, it is a difficult style. A lot of movement in and out. A little bit erratic, but it's good for Medina.
Just finding out a little more about Scott Harrison here against this style. Naturally enough, he finds it hard to look so impressive, but he's still finding some quality punches. Lovely right hand, that was a feat from Harrison.
You feel these quality punches will have an effect.
Yeah, the late rounds could be Harrison's territory. There's Medina's aging legs begin to feel very heavy. Medina's had cuts problems in the past, not tonight so far.
Just waiting a bit too long. Harrison needs to get in, try and beat Medina to the punch. Good, strong, big punches have come from Harrison in that round.
Yeah, did the better quality work, I think, Harrison there. Needed the round, though, I think. Interesting to know how the judges are seeing this, because these are rounds open to different interpretation.
Well, got the more solid punches on Harrison in that round. He really did. Couple of good right hands. There was one that shook the head of Medina. Tried with the right uppercut. Just missed with that one. But Medina is giving him problems, and it's difficult for Harrison to solve them. I've got Medina ahead by 1.48-47. Well, Harrison just coming into and looking better in the fifth.
Frank Maloney, Scott Harrison's manager, turning around at ringside and arguing with Glenn about his scoring of round two, saying that Harrison was showing the better quality shots. Well, he would say that, wouldn't he? Sixth round. Harrison, remember, in the black trunks. Unusual style, unique almost. Medina who lives in Tijuana, same town as Eric Morales, one of the world's other top featherweights, though he'll be moving up by the sounds of things. Nicely done with the left hand there by Harrison.
You sense that Medina slowing down a bit. Still moving quite well though.
Beaten a lot of good fighters, Troy Dorsey, Tom Johnson, okay, that was a technical decision. Fabrice Benishu, Frankie Toledo, Hector Lizarazu, Alejandro Gonzalez, and so on and so forth. Steve Cruz as well, Medina slips in the corner there, that's just water that had spilt.
Well, there's no doubt he is genuine world-class, all-time world champion. Pretty remarkable record for a man that turned professional at 14.
He's making a big argument out of this, Medina. Some people thought he might be blown away, that he was coming near the end of the road after what happened to him against Marquez. Not working out that way. And Harrison, by his own high standards, maybe just a little off form so far. But bear in mind, it's a tricky style. And I don't think he's truly worked it out yet.
I don't think he has. Harrison needs to be close to someone because he likes to throw lots of shots with combinations, threes and fours. You can't do that because you can't stay close enough to Medina.
Is Marquez showing other fighters the way to go about dealing with Scott Harrison?
Well, he is. Obviously had the style to deal with Medina well enough. But styles do make fights, and it is, you know, you can handle some fighters and some styles better than others. And obviously this one, movement, fast punches, is something that, you know, just worries Harrison a bit.
Just looks a little frustrated in there at the moment. Slightly bemused by the whirlwind hands of Medina.
That's the problem, getting beaten to the punch, can't get his balance.
The danger that begins to loom for Scott Harrison in this fight is that he could get himself pickpocketed out of it. That's a bit better. He needs to start cutting off Medina on the ropes and in the corners. That isn't happening. Well, we're coming up to the round, the seventh, that Scott Harrison believed he would win it. And look at the jabs landed so far.
75 to 29, that's a telling tale, isn't it? And something that Harrison has to deal with, and he has to find a way past that jab, and that's a bit of head movement and getting quicker into range.
You always know when things aren't going so well when Denny Mancini starts joining in the corner, and he talks a lot of sense usually too.
Well, he's been around that long, certainly does talk a lot of sense. Maybe Harrison just needs more of a G-up.
This is a test of Scott Harrison's world championship credentials. The staying champion means dealing with all kinds of styles from all kinds of challenges. He's closing in here. Now this is more like it from Harrison. He's got him in the corner, he's cut him off, and he got him with a lot of good shots before Medina escaped. And he needs, I think, to raise the tempo, add a bit more pace, but Medina just picks him up with a little uppercut there. Well, it's not what we thought we were going to see, is it?
That's right, I think he's been eating his beans, and I think the Mexican jumping beans that he's had.
I just wonder whether it's becoming too big an effort for Harrison to make featherweight.
Well, I know all about that. You know, when the struggles get too much, it does drain the body. But he's very, very determined, Scott Harrison. I certainly wouldn't count him out.
No, nor me. There been times when you felt he's about to solve the puzzle. Made a great start to the round, but then wasn't really built on it.
So hard to deal with this volume of punches coming at you from a tall man who's out of range to retaliate.
Harrison just misses with the right. His record doesn't suggest he's a huge puncher, in fact, Scott Harrison. Only 9 stoppages in his 19 wins. What he normally does is wear people down with his strength and pressure. Watch the use of the head, warning for Harrison there.
Well, this is Medina's round. He's worked well. Harrison started the first 20 seconds well, but since then it's been all Medina.
I think the Scottish crowd are a bit worried about what they're watching. They know this isn't like the Scott Harrison they've seen in recent fights. After all the rave reviews, maybe he was due a night where things didn't work out quite so smoothly.
Well, he's also got nose damage, and when you get that, you see blood going about a lot. Could be trouble with his breathing.
Yeah, I wonder.
It really does upset you.
Yes, he is letting his mouth gape open at times now. He's got quite a few problems in there at the moment, Harrison, and he's in danger of getting outworked in this fight. Let's go and talk to Frank Maloney, Scott Harrison's manager. How worried is he? He's with Craig Slater.
Yes, Frank Maloney urging his man on from ringside. Frank, is there a genuine concern that Scott's falling behind here?
Well, I think I've got him one round behind after that, but he seems to be falling in a pattern, and he's not. He doesn't seem to be getting the combinations going. He seems to be a bit wielded by the long arms and the quick movement of Medina.
He has a very awkward style, Medina. What can Scott do to counteract that?
I think he's just got to close the gaps down, and he's got to throw a lot more punches. He's just got to keep walking him down and throwing punches. When he does that, Medina doesn't have a response to him. But when Medina gets into a pattern, Scott seems to be a little bit bewildered.
Thanks, Frank.
Well, he seems calm enough. He thinks there's only one round in it. I think Medina's ahead by three.
Yep, that's exactly as I've got it, three rounds ahead.
Mind you, this is in Scotland. I don't know how the judges are seeing it.
Well, you can hear by the crowd that the way they're seeing it, they know there's genuine concern for Harrison.
Round eight. Harrison needs to lift it, needs to be doing more.
68-65 on my card in Medina's favour. And he's still bouncing in there in his 75th fight of his career. Still got the spring in the legs, Manuel Medina.
Having said that, there is very, very little in a lot of his punches.
There is, but they're hitting the target. They're annoying. They're getting there. They are scoring shots.
Which will cause a controversy, I'm sure. The most famous debate on that subject was, of course, the Hagler-Leonard fight in 87, where people argued that Leonard was just landing showy combinations and not real meaty punches. But he got the decision that night.
Body and head, long shots, and it certainly is troubling Harrison, who tries to get in close.
Wonder if he is having problems with that breathing. It might have been quite a good spot, that, Glenn. You see, his nose has been leaking blood for three rounds or so.
Well, he's certainly got damage there, and you just see every now and again big pumps of blood when he gets hit. And, you know, obviously, inside it's hard to breathe, and he
lost his balance there.
His head.
Harrison, no knockdown. There's a little nick too by the side of the left eye of Scott Harrison now.
Good solid right from Medina. I think Harrison got a little cut on the left eye as well to make matters worse.
Still looks ultra fresh, Medina. A wonderful conditioned featherweight he is. What a tribute to him, the way he keeps on coming back. Tag with a left-hander. Medina says he thought it was a bit of a rabbit punch. Landed round the back. Might have had a case. Great right, Medina there.
The truth of it is, he's having real trouble here, Scott Harrison.
Dabbing away, too, at his eyes. He looks a troubled fighter in there at the moment, continuing to look bemused. We thought he might find the answers, but to be honest with you, I'd like to tell you he is, but there are not that many signs of it at the moment.
There's not. There looks to be some doubt coming into his mind as well. He's unable to lift himself, getting picked off from long range. You see the blood from the nose again.
And at the moment, Medina is fighting like a man who thinks he has Harrison's number. But just to remind him that he maybe hasn't, two right hands go crashing in. but Medina significantly got himself out of trouble in that corner as the bell sounds, and I think won another round.
There's the damage to the eye that they're working on. There's nose damage. He really is in a bit of trouble here, and maybe Medina has just got his number style-wise.
Well, there's all kinds of rumours going around ringside about how this fight is being scored. Some of the promoters' officials saying that it might be four rounds by now to Medina. There he is, look at that. World featherweight title fights. The old-timers, George Dixon and Abe Attell at the top. Eusebio Pedroza, who Barry McGuigan beat to become champion, 20. Medina, 18 now at featherweight, and one other at super featherweight. What a record, and what a fighter. He's boxed 15 world champions. This leathery-skinned, super fit Mexican, who made his debut in Tijuana car parks when he was 14, right out of the spit and sawdust school. He says, I've been a fighter all my life.
Well, you have to be to come out of Tijuana, because that is one tough place. Well, four rounds to go, and I've got Medina four rounds ahead. So Harrison really has to pull something out and show why he's champion.
Well, he has to make it close-ish on the scorecards, doesn't he? He has to make there be a room for argument. Not much at the moment. There's just something not quite there with him tonight.
Yep, just hasn't got the spark. Never really looked to have that right from the beginning. Maybe it's the weight.
Yeah, maybe it is. I know he used to train with three layers of heavy clothing on in a hothouse gym, but he's going to have to show now some real championship quality to get out of jail in this one.
Well, he's trying like mad now to close the distance down. Really got Medina running about. He's got to get the arms working though, Harrison.
He has to start getting Medina left hand. Looked a heavy shot. Again, the Mexican springs like a jack in the box off those ropes and away from trouble. Maybe this will be Scott Harrison's time in the fight, though. Late on, he's been covering a lot of ground in there, almost running a marathon, Medina, on oldish legs. And he's starting to just ship a few more. Noticeably so in this round. Just breathing a little heavier too, Medina. Starting to look a bit puffed up.
Well, he really is trying to make an effort of it in this round, Harrison. You can see him focused, trying to get those arms moving, trying to rattle up the punches.
Well, he's hardly been out of the gym, has he, as well? That's another factor. His three fight preparations and biggish fights almost back to back. Well, this is a better round for Harrison, this one, though.
Maybe he just does need a little bit of a rest, and he's a bit of a jaded fighter.
Just starting to get to Medina here. Oh, lowish right hand from Harrison. Keep them up, says Mickey Van, the referee. Van, a referee who likes the limelight himself. Enjoys being part of these world championship fights. Harrison's won that one. Needed it badly too.
But he looked to be trying very hard in that round. How much is that round taken out of Scott Harrison? Can he keep it going? Because he needs to.
Gary Jacobs is talking to Ed Robinson. Let's hear what he has to say.
Well, Gary, you don't actually think that Scott Harris has won a single round yet.
No, I think he's laboring. I think he's really struggling. He just can't seem to cope with the jab and move. It's a bit amateur tactics. He's standing in front of the guy. Medina's just jabbing and moving and picking up points. Not that he's worked that clever. Scott's worked a little bit better, but he's not doing enough of it.
So he's running out of time, Scott Harrison. You've got him booked for defeat, really.
Absolutely. I think he's got to. I mean, in realistic terms, I think he has to stop him here to win the fight. He's not going to win it, in my opinion, he's not going to win it in points.
Thank you, Gary.
Medina significantly more punches thrown and landed in this fight. Harrison, slightly better success rate. I've still got it by 3 points to Medina with three rounds to go. Are we in for a big shock here tonight? What do the scorecards of the judges say?
Well, he really does need to get a few ideas in there of what to do to cut off the ring, to get close, and most of all, to get those punches thrown.
Harrison's plans for greatness put on hold a bit here. I think they'll have to abandon all that talk about Marco Antonio Barrera for the time being, whatever the result here.
Well, like every fighter, there's always a way to beat them, and Manuel Medina just looks to be finding the way with Harrison.
Medina was stopped in the 11th by the big punching Nassim Hamed, but he had a great 12th against Paul Ingall, floored him and nearly pulled it out the fire that night in a classic.
Well, there's real Mexican pride with Medina. He hasn't come here to make the numbers up, whether people think his career is on the slide or not.
Did we ever think he had?
No.
He's making a nonsense of a lot of the pre-fight predictions here. Manuel Medina, and Harrison looks tired. Gary Jacobs doesn't think he's won a round. I think that's a bit unfair, but I think there's not much doubt Medina's ahead.
And Gary's Scottish as well, so I wouldn't be a biased view.
Harrison has lost before, but that was on a cut against Miguel Matthews early in his career. Hardly matters. This would be a genuine and very damaging defeat.
Well, I think there's something wrong with Harrison. Yeah. He's jaded. I think it's been too much of a struggle to make the weight. He hasn't had the spark of old right from the start.
And at the moment, he looks like he could be sliding to defeat unless he can come up with something spectacular later on here.
Well, we know what he's made of. We know how strong a character he is, but he's going to need every bit of that.
His punches just seem to bounce off Medina, even the big heavy ones.
Well, Medina's done well, really found a rhythm, really got the punches going, warmed up to this pretty quickly, and it's been a tremendous performance from Medina.
Well, they thought he was shot when they hired him to fight Alejandro Gonzalez. He won the WBC title. They thought he was shot when they hired him to fight Hector Lizarraga in a first defense for the IBF title. He won that too. Is he going to do it all over again with Scott Harrison? Tell you what, Frank Maloney's reputation's on the line a little bit here, you know. He's the guy that chose Medina as the opponent.
Well, they wanted good fighters. You've got to credit them for doing that, but have they done it? Have they picked a mistake? Scott Harrison wants to fight Barrera. He wants to fight the Moraleses of this world. Medina is not that. You know, And this is who he's in with, and he's struggling desperately. Four rounds behind on my card with two rounds to go.
Had some hard sparring ahead of this fight as well with Eric Odumasi, a Ghanaian who was one of his old foes. Apparently those sessions very, very intense in the gym.
Well, you know, hot gyms, hot sessions, weight making, all makes for, you know, just taking a little bit out of a fighter.
And the hard fights back to back. Not that it was particularly hard one against McCulloch for him. Totally dominant that night. Well, well, well. Round 11. Have we got to the stage where Harrison needs a stoppage or knockout? Plenty of scorecards think so. That looked like a bit of a low one. Medina went to complain and then just got straight back to the game plan. Couldn't be bothered to do it. Too busy. Got on the balls of his feet. There's a right to the body. And Medina isn't stopping. Desperation shots, but he's having to throw all caution aside here. Harrison now, as he tries to rescue what on the face of it looks a losing cause, unless the judges do him a favor. in his home city.
I think they'll tell him in the corner that you're behind, you're in danger of losing this. You need the knockout, because he is trying to make a big effort to get close, and he is planting his feet and really throwing the haymakers.
Medina has done so much work in this contest. Is he going to last home? Can Harrison somehow, sensationally, nail him late? Breathing heavily, cut by the side of the eye, blood from the nose, looking jaded.
He's looking really, really tired in there. This is a mammoth effort for Harrison to get the punches out.
It's just not happened for him tonight. And even with Medina's big pedigree, if Harrison does lose it, it would be one of the year's big shocks.
Well, he needs a huge punch to get Medina out of there. He doesn't look like he's got the strength to do that. Medina has got the bounce. Harrison hangs on, and he's tired.
Just hasn't been able to sustain any pressure. And that was a good right hand. I don't know why Medina was complaining. He was right into the right side of his temple, and that's flush. Harrison lands again. Medina just soaks it up, though. And there's another very heavy shot. Now then, can he get to Medina? No, the Mexican is still bouncing around on the balls of his feet. Well, this is a good part of the fight now for Harrison. Good little half a minute.
Medina still there, still throwing out the shot. The eye closing of Harrison, that left eye, as well as the nose damage. He's got that to contend with.
Take absolutely nothing for granted ever in this business. Only one round to go. Big crisis here, and you can feel that the Harrison fan club, the thousands of them here, know it.
Well, 269 punches to 197 landed for Medina. Look at that. And Harrison's face showing every one of those shots.
Frank Maloney's gone round to Harrison's corner, probably to tell him he needs a knockout. And I've just seen something I've never seen in my life. Frank Maloney turned down an interview with a radio man at ringside. You ever seen him do that?
Never. I think he knows. I don't think he can speak, really. I think he's been shouting that hard for Harrison.
He's lifted off his stool, literally lifted by his father, Scott Harrison. Last round, weeping. Harrison needs a knockout. But I just wonder whether we're going to have a controversy. What happens here in this last round? Harrison just has to throw the kitchen sink at Medina. You just can't believe this is his 19th world title fight, spanning a decade or more, can you? Manuel Medina, 12 years to be exact.
Yeah, it really is remarkable to show, to have such freshness, to be bouncing around the ring, letting shots go when you've been through a career that he has.
All those fights against a man 7 years younger, away from home as well. Sure, Medina's corner will be thinking, well, we think we've got it, but they won't start celebrating until they hear the judges' cards. The eye is closing of Harrison, who's looked tired for a long time, almost as if he's fighting from memory. He's really having to drag it up from somewhere. He just has not looked himself tonight, and it hasn't only been the fact that he's fighting a different style. There's Medina slipping on some water. That rather slippery advertising in the centre of the ring as well. You can look at that, I think, the authorities.
Well, you do have to say what a tremendous job Manuel Medina's done here. Absolutely fantastic. The amount of shots he's landed, punches he's thrown.
but he lost to Johnny Tapia when he threw 1400. Well, the judges thought so anyway.
The judges thought so. That was better from Harrison.
He has landed a few solid ones here and there, but he hasn't been able to sustain the pressure. Medina's never really let him get set. He's always throwing out some leather with those red gloves. Harrison just hasn't got close enough, often enough.
Body shot seemed to hurt Harrison there.
Is the most talked about featherweight in the country and one of the most talked about boxers in the country on his way here to a shock defeat.
Well, on my card, definitely, I think it is the end of a title for Scott Harrison.
And it's a low blow from Medina there. Harrison makes nothing of it. But that's a desperation throw there from the Scott. This style has found him out, hasn't it? I don't think he's really fought anybody quite like this. A mover, lateral movement, on his toes, throw punches, away again. And he's made Harrison look ponderous. It's over, and unless there's a robbery, Medina takes the title, I think.
Yeah, I think most definitely Medina did a lot more. Won the rounds, and I think it's a big win, a fantastic win for Manuel Medina.
You've got to take your hats off to Medina, whether he gets it or not. We shall wait to see. Larry Hazard Jr., Melvin Latham, and Britain's Roy Francis will score it. Harrison bearing the scars of battle. Those are the three pretty experienced officials.
Listen to the crowd, Ian. Virtual silence.
Medina once again threw more than 1,000 punches to Harrison, 749. He landed with nearly 100 more. Okay, they weren't perhaps of the quality of Harrison's shots, but I don't think there's any two ways about it. If justice is served here, Medina has won.
Most definitely, and really, you know, after a performance like that, you wouldn't want to see him robbed of his fifth world title. How remarkable is that?
I've got it by 4 points to Medina, and that might be being a bit kind to Harrison.
Yeah, I've just looking at mine, I'm 6, I think, for Medina.
A nasty shock for the Scottish crowd. It was a bit of a gala weekend up here with the Scottish Open golf going on and a big rock concert with REM. City buzzing a bit, but nobody's buzzing in that Harrison corner now. I think they know the score. Look at Denny Mancini's face. That is not the face of a corner or the faces of a corner who think they've got it. Harrison looks like he knows he's lost the fight, doesn't he?
Yeah, I think he does. I think some words maybe leaked to them. Medina. He's in the corner, he's standing on the ropes.
And if it's true, Manuel Medina will be a 5-time world champion for Mexico. There'll be a big inquest about what went wrong. Not a great night for Frank Maloney, who had a choice of 2 or 3 people who might have fought Harrison. He picked Medina, thought Harrison would have his number. It didn't look like it. Here it is officially.
Ladies and gentlemen, the judges have concluded that we have a split decision. Judge Roy Francis scores the contest 118 to 113 for Manuel Medina. Judge Larry Hazard Jr. scores the contest 115 to 113 for Scott Harrison. And Judge Melvina Latham scores the contest 116 to 112. For the winner by split decision and new.
Medina's got it by a split decision. Harrison has lost his title and deservedly so. No doubts at all about it. Justice has been served. And frankly, Larry Hazard Jr. should be the subject of a big inquiry by the WBO. How could his card read that? That is a scandal, Glenn.
That is an absolute scandal. And you know, luckily, the other two judges had it right, and the right man won this. But that was from Larry Hazard, absolute jaw.
Scott, you lose your world title on a split decision. Did you think you'd lost by more, though?
No, I just didn't. It just wasn't there, innit? I didn't look so sharp. I don't know. It was quite slippery. I thought it was a close fight.
You thought it was close, but you had problems from the beginning with his grab and raid tactics and his movement. Why couldn't you close him down?
Because he was just trying to kind of steal it, and he was slippery. And the sharpness wasn't there.
And also problems with your nose, difficulty breathing at times?
The guy put up a good fight. No, he put up a good fight.
And what about in training? Anything that went wrong? How was the weight making? Were you struggling at that?
No problems. I was old a couple of weeks ago, but the guy put up a good fight. I mean, done well.
Fairly and squarely beaten by a better man on the night.
I need to look at it.
Frank Maloney, what do you think? Do you think that the judges got it right, or two of them got it right?
Well, I think Medina just stole the fight with his grab, with his jab and grab style, but we'll be back. I mean, you know, I'm sure Frank Warren will get a rematch made and Scott will get back. And, you know, on the night he got beat, he just had a bad day at the office. That's all it is.
Very upsetting for you, obviously, knowing how much time and effort you've put into Scott and how close you are.
Well, it's upsetting for the whole team. You know, it's upsetting for Britain because he was a good world champion, but he will be back.
You'll be back, Scott.
Definitely.
Thanks for your honesty and talking to us. Cheers.
The unthinkable had happened. Harrison couldn't get firing, and the 32-year-old Mexican took the title from under his nose. Harrison got serious, however, and won the title back in the rematch before finally retiring in 2005.